Please, friend, stay a while and enjoy the beauty of the gardens. When you get back to the roads, make sure you keep a tight fist on your coin purse if you pass through the traveler's camp. Good day.
Welcome. Welcome.
Always open for business when the road is your marketplace. Are you looking to buy items or sell them? Always looking to make a bit of coin?
The dust of the road rises to meet you, Wanderer. Welcome to Star Camp. I am Kilgarin. I am unfamiliar with the title the Knave of Coins. But as I understand, it grants me responsibility for this camp and its travelers. I know the lands and shadows and winding paths the travelers use. I heed no law or creed of property. For that, I am given leadership. When others feared to even speak to Fae, Grim came and introduced me to the travelers. Ever since, a more stalwart ally I cannot think of. This place has been walked by many, and this copse was hollowed ground once. We maintain it. We are many things, but what the travelers are to most are thieves. We follow our own way. You are young among our number. I would not color your perceptions of the Hierophant with my own. Then Grim has appraised you and found you of worth. But there is another you must appease, our guide, the anonymous Hierophant. Go to the Hierophant shrine in our camp and pray, as all travelers must. We have many freedoms and one chain. A traveler lives by his or her hands and guile. You must do the same. Trader Hyden sells items to supplement these skills if you need. Travelers have clever hands, but they are useless without the Hierophant, whose eyes guide us, a gift upon which we've come to rely. To receive the Hierophant's visions, we are commanded to pray at their shrines, and there are many who readily comply. May the wind be at your back. What prays before me? An eddy in the river of fate, a cacophony in the song of Amalur. Your presence is unnerving. But you have come and prayed, and honored our creeds. You wish to make yourself a traveler? Then ask me for my portents. For true trust, for true compliance, the Hierophant must have no weakness, nor fault, nor lapse. In other words, the Hierophant must be no one. The price to admit you is great. It will take 3 treasures to balance the burden. First, there is a noble Elfwig Grilvrakas staying in Dyden Hill. Steal his medallion. Then, in the nearby mission, claim the pall of the dead Saint Edrix. The last are Drog's toothpicks. We have contacted their owner, Gunnar Frode, to buy the items. But you will steal them instead. It is the rather valuable bauble of an old noble family. Rather mundane, but worth much coin to us. The daggers used by the fabled Jotun Warmaster Draug, though they were not his weapons, as the name suggests. It is the burial shroud of Saint Edric. There are many collectors of relics who hunger for these artifacts and pay dearly for them. Yes, some final warnings. Elfwig Grilvrakas is a fastidious man. He will not suffer an approach, he can see. The pall of Edric lies in his tomb, which is under many eyes. Wait until none are near before you claim it. And last, Gunnar Frode is shifty. He will not have the daggers on him or near him. Be warned.
Hello, child.
I hope you find your stay here peaceful.
Welcome to St. Edric's. You're here to meet with Father Ataire, yes? The Father's always playing host to interesting individuals such as yourself. His quarters are on the second floor of the Mission Bunkhouse. Most of his days are spent inside working on his research. I don't understand a word of it. No, I knew that they were arguing, but I never imagined that it would lead to murder. It's enough to make a man question his faith. Five years in the swamps of Clericon was enough to rid me of my lust for war. I was an impetuous youth, raised by the back of my father's right hand. But I found home here with the others. All we seek is a sliver of peace in this vast world. Father Ataire and his apprentice brother Wolf, they were inseparable. Like a true father and son. It was a shared love of alchemy that brought them together. But since their work repairing the village well, they've been acting tense, even hostile. Just this morning I saw Ataire fetching water. But now he's gone. Mitharu, save us all. You're free to search the bunkhouse. Please, if you can shed any light on this tragedy, we'll do all we can to assist you. In another life, Wolf was a butcher in Galifor. He's a naive sort, and his gifts do not lie in prayer. But Father Ataire believed that Wolf had been called. It dried up several months ago, so we sent several brothers down to try and find some deeper reserves. Father Ataire had great interest in Mitharu's natural splendors. He volunteered to lead the project, with Wolf by his side, of course. I'll admit that the eastern lands are beautiful in their own way. Like Dalentarth, the forests and swamps are ruled by fey folk, but a far more sinister variety. Clericon should be seen, but I advise that you wait until after the war passes before you pay your ship's passage. I know only what I've seen from this hill. The fey are a wild race, inspired by the intimacy with the natural world. We at the Mission marvel at this relationship. Occasionally, Father Ataire would play host to a visiting summer court fey, but I know nothing of the meetings, except that many of the brothers frowned upon them. Father Ataire and his apprentices conducted many experiments. He had a strong interest in alchemy and the magic of other races. There's proof of it everywhere. Bless you, child. Come, rest a spell.
Yes, I have a moment I can spare for you. Stay safe. Thank you.
but you will not have the crystals. They are mine. Don't make me kill another.
That was my name, yes. But it means nothing now. And after everything I've seen, everything I've done, I'm a cursed soul now. Mitharu has chewed me up and spit me out. I lost my true father in the mines of Apatir. Many ways Atair took his place. Taught me to respect hard work, discipline, the blessing of order in a chaotic world. They radiate a strange, wild magic. A force that can cause change, or even destruction. The witch wishes to use the crystals to corrupt other types of magic. I had no choice. It was trying to destroy the crystals. He didn't understand that we'd been chosen, that the crystals wanted us to possess them. The strange woman was right. She knew the crystals' power. That's why she wanted them. But we told her nothing. When she left, Father dropped the crystals back into the well. But they sang to me, told me to kill him. Rescue them. Their voices. So beautiful. The crystals give off a glorious music. Can you not hear? It speaks to me. I've spent hours playing my whistle and watching the crystals shimmer with joy. Father Atair believed that the magic within the crystals responded to the tones and rhythms of song, almost as if they were a living thing. She was a fae, quite beautiful, called herself the Maid of Windermere. Father Atair was suspicious of her kindness and threw the crystals down the well. It was his idea to lie when the maid asked him about the crystal's properties, its strength. Endless questions, but he told her nothing. I haven't found it yet. I was searching the well tunnels when I was attacked by kobolds. Nasty things. Father Atair did something to the crystal. Hid it by way of magic. Priest using magic. Unforgivable. Why would I want to do that? The song of the crystal is the only truth that has ever kept its promise of power. Mitharu? Never. Father Atair? No. The maid was right. The crystal gives the power to end the pain. And now, I choose to end yours. Go!
You haven't seen an angry-looking Docklefar, have you? Pointy beard? No. People call me a thief, but I've never stolen anything. Occasionally I'll use other people's houses while they're away. I don't see what they're so angry about. So I have to come out here now and again to let things in town cool off. Always attracts a few treasure hunters, convinced the ruins are full of ancient riches. Bunch of lunatics, if you ask me. Nothing to it, really. You just need to get the feel for it. Once you have that, no door stays locked for long.
Village plagued. To find a cure for them, her quest, the Maid of Windermere, her test. She faced the evil maid enraged. She trembled with her wrath. Undo your evil magic now, or I will end this tale, I vow.
Thank you. The season is upon us. The time of the flowering is come. Yet I fear there'll be no ceremony. No flowering. No joy. Every new leaf in Boggart's dance I see brings joy to my heart. But nothing equals my joy at the flowering. Yes, you might call it that. But I say, our woods, our streams, our ancient stones, we are theirs as much as they are ours. The flowering is our ballad, Bodrill's and mine. But he has not returned, so cannot play his part. Our story cannot be relived, cannot be retold. I do not understand how this could be. When the time of the flowering draws near, Bodrill arrives. It's then we set to work, he in his way and I in mine. Only this time, he's delayed. He has not come. Why, it is the finest, most miraculous thing. It is... There is no worthy description. But alas, Bodrill has not returned. With no one to play his part, I fear it is not to be. I asked the mortal maid for help, but she refused. I have resigned myself to sorrow. She was looking for one of her kind. I asked if she would help with the flowering. I was very patient. I explained that the ceremony was far more important than her lost friend, but she would not have it. Mortals. Why, Bodrill is... Well, he always returns to take part in the flowering. Only now the season has come, but he has not. Why, I cannot say. Go. He has returned to the great cycle, of course. He gives himself to the flowering, and the ceremony is complete. Then I rejoice. Bodrill's first task, your first task, I mean, is to gather the chrysalis. The chrysalis are seeds of sorts. You'll find them throughout the woods. When you've gathered them, seek me in Brunwarth Hollow. That task was Bodrill's. They spread throughout Lochcarain, of that I'm certain. There's more to mortals than I had thought.
There was another named Owl. This name was to be feared. The name is death, decay, and violence. A cold and fading moment. A mind not of misery in the few leaves of winter. A suit of armor beneath which lay a void. Where Issa's vision was of cultured landscapes, his was of the choking weeds. Owl's reach devoured the land. The winter approached.